Hello everyone. In the last video, I showed you that how you can implement one-time in-app purchases in your apps. Today, with the same extension, I will be showing you how can you implement in-app subscription in your app. I will be adding two time period subscription in our app, which is monthly and yearly. As you can see, I have already created this subscription with two base plans, month and yearly. You must upload your app to Play Store after you create this subscription, otherwise the subscription will not be loaded in your app. I have already created a demo design for subscribing and have added some blocks that I already showed in the previous video. Now, let's code and understand the logic behind subscription. As I said earlier that whenever the billing service is connected, then billing client setup finished event is triggered, and the first thing we will do is to query the subscription to find whether the user is already subscribed or not. Since this is subscription, so we will use in-app subscription property this time. The almost process is same for both subscription and in-app purchases. When the active purchase will be fetched, query purchase response event will be triggered with the list of all active subscriptions. Same like earlier, we will use the same concept and block to find the subscription status. Now we will use if block to hide the subscribe arrangement if the user is already subscribed, and if not, then we'll use the get subscription details to fetch the subscription details for the purchase. Now, when the subscription details will be fetched, got subscription details event will be raised. Here we have to store product details and other details for initiating the purchase. So we will now declare some variable with empty value and will use them to store the prices and offer tokens. Now I have stored the values and variable that I got from the event. In the design, as you know, we have used two radio buttons to select the plan, and our monthly radio button will be checked by default, so I will use the checked property to check it. Now I will take the another variable that will hold the current selected plan value. I am initializing it with the default month value. Also make sure that the values should be matching to the base plan ID of your subscription. Since we have used the radio buttons to select the plans, we need to handle their check event and set the selection according to it. We will be updating the subscription price on the button label whenever the user changes the choice. For that, we will create a procedure that will set the price of the selected plan. As of now, we have already stored the price and other details in global variable from the got subscription details event. We will use it here to get the price according to the selected plan. We will use the price list variable to get the price. And since we have stored the selection in a variable, we will use it with base plan ID list variable to find the index for getting the price, and we will use the same thing to find index of the offer token during subscribing. We have almost finished. Now we will use the card click to initiate the subscription purchase. Here we have an offer token. Different plans have different offer tokens, and we use them to launch a specific subscription. For example, we have two plans here and both have different offer token. We will get the offer token of selected plan as same as price. We have finished launching the billing flow. Now we will use purchase successful event to acknowledge the subscription. Remember that you can't consume a subscription, you must acknowledge it. Also we'll be showing a simple subscribed alert when the subscription will be acknowledged. And for refreshing the UI, just query the active subscription again. We have finished the job, now let's export and test our app. I made a mistake while checking the product details variable on card click. I must have used the string instead of the list here. Now done. Let's export it again and check it. I have opened the app, and as you can see, it's showing the subscribed false, meaning that we have not subscribed, and it's showing the price on the button on the radio button selection. Now let's click on the button and subscribe the purchase. the subscription flow is launched and showing it's a test purchase with test time of 5 minutes. If you want to see the correct time of the plan, then you may check it from the real account. We got the alert and the subscribe layout has been hidden now, meaning we are subscribed. Let's open the app again and see if it's working. And it's showing true, means we successfully implemented the in-app subscription in our app. So this was the tutorial of handling multi-time period subscription in your app. I hope you liked it. If you have some question regarding it, then you can ask in the comment. I will be making more tutorial to explore more extensions, so stay tuned and thanks for watching.